Hey everyone, welcome back to Genshin Impact, where today we're just going to continue doing these story quests now. So I guess we'll just do this one here, and we'll unlock it. Alright. So, oh yeah, it should be back here. Yeah, alright. Gotta leave Lemon Heart. Alright. We gotta leave it. Alright, guess we have to go to it first. Here it is. Alright, we gotta go there and then leave it. Alright. There she is. Alright, let's go.
Finally! Almost fell asleep waiting. As usual, my predictions are correct. You, yes you, come with me.
What? Why?
Are you some sort of door-to-door fortune teller? Sorry, but we're not really interested.
You're not from this world, are you?
Oh. Alright then.
Does my ability to see through your secrets so easily not evoke any memories?
Yeah. You remember.
Oh, Paimon remembers! You're that astrologist!
That's right. It is I, Astrologist Mona Magistus. This time, I would like you to come with me to Mondstadt to reclaim a box that belongs to my master. It was part of an agreement she made with a friend 50 years ago. But she isn't as spry as she used to be, so now it's up to me.
Not sure what getting some box back has to do with us. Why do you need us to come along?
Yeah.
Well, that's because I would also like to take on the guardian of the box. My master and her friend contended in the mystic arts all their lives without a clear victor. If I triumph here, then I will show myself to be superior to my master.
Alright, so she wants to make herself look good.
Yeah. What are you talking about? The main thing here is to use this chance to prove the power and status of astrology. Now, from my predictions, I know that my master's friend has left Mondstadt, leaving her successor as the current guardian of that box. Like me, that successor must also be one who has surpassed their teacher. I must not be careless. But I would prefer to assure my victory in this contest, and upon giving it some thought, you came to mind.
Alright, so why us?
The knowledge passed down to me from my master must be passed on in turn. If I were to bring my disciple to meet her, then the lead is already mine, no? And you are Mondstadt's great hero, my equal in status, so...
Yeah, well, why do we have to do it?
Come on, you don't actually have to become my disciple. You just need to act the part. There's something in it for you as well, should you come with me to get that box. Once I meet that successor and have a chance to exchange knowledge with them, I should be able to read your fate more accurately. Then I will have answers for you, even regarding such distant and foggy matters as gods and kin.
Ah.
That does seem much faster than searching the land country by country.
Alright then, we could do that.
A wise decision. That said, I would like to pay a certain place a visit before we go.
Huh.
There is a small inn near Mount Tianhong that never sees a lot of business, even though its food is always great value for the money. The owner has always been good to me, so I'd like to say a farewell before I set off.
Alright. So, this place. Oh, how about that stuff there?
This life isn't bad either.
What about you? What are you doing here? Bluffy. Alright, let's talk to him now.
Well? No wonder that an inn set up here has no business.
Mona, you've come at just the right time. Did you see a jade ring while you made your way here?
A jade ring. Can't say I have.
Oh, that's not good. That ring was given to me by my mother, but while my back was turned, it was swallowed up by a slime.
Oh.
That should be no trouble with Mona here. She's really good at astrology.
Absolutely not. Astrology is meant to be used to gain insight into reality and observe destiny itself. It's certainly not for such mundane affairs.
But didn't you say that the owner here's been good to you?
This is a matter of pride and one's state of mind. If an astrologist thinks that their arts can solve all problems, they will be forsaken by the starry ether. Their divinations will lose the power to guide and will not be able to pierce the fog of the unknown before them. Principles are principles.
Such a powerful ability, and you don't use it to earn a living? What a shame.
Well, I was going to put up 20,000 mora as compensation, if you were willing.
Ah.
20,000?
She's gonna want to do it now.
Oh, it's nothing. I was just thinking that the person who finds that ring must be lucky indeed to be able to earn 20,000 mora just like that.
Yeah, she was just talking about this stuff, astrologist pride.
Yes, of course. Still, the owner's business has had it pretty hard. It must be a truly extraordinary ring to be worth spending this much mora to find. It wouldn't be right for us to leave like this, so let's help to search for it. There may be other means we can employ besides astrology.
Oh, Paimon knows where this is going.
I know. I'll leave this one to you. This is the first mission I'm giving you as your master.
All right, then. Yeah.
Since it was swallowed up by a slime, maybe we can use elemental bait to lure all the nearby slimes to us. You remember the stuff we helped Master Diluc make?
Yeah, we could do that.
And Paimon actually kept a small amount.
Alright. Well, good job.
Paimon's the very best partner, right?
Seems like you already have a plan.
Yep, we'll be back in a jiffy.
Alright.
The elemental bait's really strong. It will attract all the slimes in the area. Even if they're just slimes, they can be dangerous together, so we'd best prepare ourselves.
Alright.
This is your first mission, so don't mess it up. But if the going gets too tough for you, well, I shall lend a hand then.
You? Oh. Alright then. So, let me get this to work. Yeah. Oh, you have to put it there. Alright, let me just get these. And now we'll do it. Yeah. There we go. Hey, I guess we'll just get the swirl thing. Yeah.
Get out of here! Out of the way! Why do they never miss?
Alright. This isn't too bad. Oh. Okay, still not too bad.
Windblade!
Oh, it's more of them.
Take cover!
Alright. Okay, so maybe I can make them both get picked up by a tornado? Oh. Alright, well, this might take a while then.
Windblade!
Oh. There's more. Alright,
no one escapes by some...
Windblade!
There we go.
Get out of here! Take cover!
Yeah. Oh. Alright.
Windblade!
Yeah, come on.
Take cover!
Alright, we're doing good.
Windblade!
Oh, froze one of those guys. Oh.
Found it! This must be the so pretty. Paimon's sure it's worth a ton of... Paimon wasn't having any bad thoughts. Let's bring the ring back to Mr. Zhu.
All right, then. Let me get this stuff first. Yeah. All right, we got it.
That's it. That's the one. Ah, I thought it was lost forever.
You actually found it. Not bad. Mr. Zhu, you must take care of such precious things a bit better. You might not be so fortunate next time.
You're absolutely right. How would I have faced my family if I had lost the 253rd ring my mother gave me? Let me explain. My family owns 3 jade mines, and in order to ensure that I would be able to find myself a good wife, my mother had many jade accessories made as heirlooms. I think there might be over 500 of them.
Wait, so he lost almost half of them?
Really? Then why would you feel the need to set up an inn here?
Well, inheriting the family business too early unavoidably made things boring. Thank you, all the same. Here's the Mora, as agreed. Please take it.
Then I'll take it, gladly.
Oh. Alright, that was quick.
But we did all the work!
A disciple should act like one. How can they steal their master's thunder?
Hey. You didn't do anything. I don't know
you. Exactly!
Well, you need to start practicing now. If my rival is as smart as I think they are, they will figure you out in a heartbeat.
What was that rumbling sound?
Hunger?
Oh, right. You mustn't have eaten in days. I'm very sorry. I forgot that you have no...
That didn't happen. Forget it. Well... I suddenly feel that you have indeed contributed to our good fortune. I say we spend this money on treating you to a fine meal. If we travel north, we'll reach the Wangshu Inn. I hear the food there is really good, so let's go try it out. No need to thank me. I'm just doing as a good master should.
Did she say she was treating us? Is Paimon hearing things?
Yeah. Alright, let's go then. Yeah.
Let's go after her for good food!
I wonder if we can spend all that prize money on the food. Hey.
Thank you all so much. You're welcome to drop by again. Well, if this inn hasn't closed its doors yet...
Isn't bad either. Alright then. There they are. Alright.
Since it's Mona's treat, we can order whatever we want, right?
Oh.
Of course. I am a most generous master, after all. But only if you can finish it all. Wasting food simply will not do.
Excuse me, what would you like to order?
Yeah, anything that costs 20,000 mora? Oh. Or shrimp balls, I guess.
These are made using large, succulent shrimp wrapped in crispy fried potatoes. They have an amazing texture.
Hmm. Oh. We're going to order them all? Alright then.
All of them? We only have 3. No, 2.5 people? Isn't that too much food?
Now we're good.
That's not how you count it. Besides, Paimon hasn't even ordered yet.
Oh.
Squirrelfish, Juju chili chicken, and Juju soup, please.
Sure. And is there anything else you'd like to order, ma'am?
I'd just like to ask, how much do the current dishes cost in total?
20,000 mora?
Around 20,000 mora.
Yes!
Then, I'll just have some vegetarian noodles, please.
Alright. Yeah. Alright, food arrives, we eat everything. Oh.
Paimon's been thinking about something since we started eating.
Why should order one dish? We spent all of our money. That's why.
Is it? Because she actually doesn't have money?
I heard that. I said I was treating. How could I be rattled by something as mundane as Mora? An astrologist's mind is set on studying the stars. Being so easily disturbed by such banal matters would hamper my judgment. Especially the act of overly gratifying oneself using Mora. It is both vulgar... ...and dangerous.
So, not eating the dishes we ordered is also part of an astrologist's pride? Paimon doesn't get it. But it feels kind of bad that only we got to feast.
No, that was our money. We did all the work.
Oh, yes! We can do that! Just give us a minute. You don't use Mora to fulfill your desires, so it's fine as long as you're not buying anything, right? Let's go borrow the kitchen from the innkeeper.
There's no need to spend all that effort on me. I'm not in dire need of food. I am a little hungry, but it's not a big deal.
See? It's not a big deal. I'm gonna do this. Yeah. Oh, look. There's a guy with an exclamation mark around here. Let's talk to him. Maybe he wants help. There he is. Alright. What? Alright, fine, let's just make the food. Done this. Yeah, look. Cabbages. Already halfway there.
Hello. Hey. How may I help you?
We'd like to borrow the kitchen here.
Yeah, for a friend.
Yeah. Ah, I see. In that case, sure. As long as you've prepared your own ingredients, feel free to use the kitchen. If I may add one more thing, you must be quite well versed in the art of cooking, yes?
Yeah, pretty much.
Talented indeed. Actually, I have a small suggestion to make. From your clothes, you're most likely not from around these parts. But since you've come to Liyue, would you like to try making Liyue-style cuisine? I have a recipe for golden crab with me. It's a Liyue cuisine classic. It's crab meat that's been rolled in flour, deep-fried, and then pan-fried together with ginger and garlic. When you finally plate up, the crab seems to be lying on gold.
Golden crab!
Yeah. Let's do it.
Golden crab! Golden crab!
Yeah. Alright, let's do it then.
Then let's get to it! With your skills in the kitchen, this'll be a cinch.
Alright. Got the recipe. Alright, come on. Alright. These recipes. And finally this one. Golden crab. Alright. So, oh, here it is. So, yeah, we have all this stuff. Let's do it then. Right. You do it. Alright. I think we should make some more, though. For later. I have to give her a good one.
There's no need to spend all that effort on me. I'm not in dire need of food.
Alright.
I am a little hungry. But it's not a big deal.
Alright. Oh. You already have 8 of them? Alright, give her a good one then. Or... we could not waste a good one. No, let's just do this one.
This aroma is...
your special order? Something goes with your new.
I never thought it'd be so luxurious. Fine, since my disciple has put in so much time and effort, I must, with great difficulty, accept. This golden crab is too delicious. I have never eaten anything this good in my life. I never knew that my disciple was this skilled. As your master, I am most comforted.
Yeah.
I see that it's no boast to call them Liyue's delicacies. I suppose it wasn't too much to spend all this mora on. It's nothing. Nothing at all. Now that we've eaten and drank our fill, we should be off. If we travel north from here, we should reach the Stone Gate, and from there, we will be within the boundaries of Mondstadt. What deep mysteries shall we acquire knowledge of? I'm looking forward to it.
All right, then. Okay, so head for Stone Gate. Okay. Alright, so this is the place.
Whew, that was tiring, but we're finally in Mondstadt. The quest to plumb the wondrous depths of knowledge is indeed arduous.
Paimon's not tired.
That's because you float.
Well, it doesn't look like an astrologist is all that amazing either.
That's because you have too many unrealistic fantasies about astrology.
Are you also resting your feet here?
Who are you?
Oh, my brothers and I are all merchants. We just finished doing business in Liyue, and we're preparing to head back to Mondstadt. You look rather tired. The cart we hired will be coming in a while. What say you to coming along for the ride?
I can't say no.
Well, let's go then. We can make conversation along the way. The more, the merrier.
There's no need. Now, shoo, get out of our way.
Yeah.
Huh? Miss, is there something wrong?
Cease your pretensions, bandit. Picking up people on the road who appear vulnerable, robbing them blind once they've gotten on the cart, and then taking them to some Archon-forsaken place. Is that your deal?
What are you saying? We came over here to make conversation, and this is how we're rewarded? With insults?
All right, they're definitely thieves now.
If you don't want to get on, don't. Crazy girl.
Well then, shall I tell you now which objects you have on you that are stolen? If you have any quibbles, we can bring people to corroborate what I've said, and all will come to light. If I lose, I'll pay you 20,000 mora. But if I win, then you'll be eating prison rations in Liyue Harbor tonight. How about it? If you're real legitimate businessmen, there's nothing to fear, is there?
You've pushed it too far, brat. I don't know how you found out, but as long as we get rid of you, no one will have to know.
You're random strangers who ask to get in your cart. Then you ask how we know. Really? Okay.
Don't fret, it's just a few bandits. You said earlier that there was nothing amazing about astrologists? Well then, this is a good time to show you what your master can do.